In 1990, the crew of a Panamax bulk carrier abandoned their vessel in the North Pacific Ocean after a fire in the engine room got out of control. All 34 crew members took refuge in the ship's survival crafts and were rescued without any casualties. In that very year, the crew of a mini bulk carrier was not that fortunate. When their stricken ship took in water in the Baltic Sea, only 3 out of a crew of 28 survived. Investigations revealed that the crew were unable to launch the ill-maintained survival crafts and perished in the sub-zero temperature. Modern ships are extraordinarily seaworthy crafts, built to exacting standards of construction and outfitted with technology worthy of spaceships. However, even the best ships can capsize or sink with terrifying speed. And equipment is only as good as the personnel who operate it. Thus, it is essential that shipboard crew is aware of the principles and techniques of sea survival and well trained in the use of survival equipment. The life-saving appliances to be carried by ships must be in accordance with the SOLAS or Safety of Life at Sea Convention, Chapter 3, and with any additional requirements of the National Administration. Every person on board should be familiar with the contents of the muster list, the general emergency alarm, and the location of the emergency stations. The muster list describes the emergency alarm signals and the action to be taken by the crew and passengers when this alarm is sounded. It further describes the special duties assigned to some crew members, which include closing of watertight doors, fire doors, scuppers, ventilators, etc. Preparation of survival crafts and other life-saving appliances. Proper muster of crew and passengers. Special duties assigned to crew pertaining to the use of firefighting equipments and installations. Officers responsible for maintenance of life-saving and firefighting appliances, and how the order to abandon ship will be given. Life jackets will not sustain burning after being totally enveloped in a fire for a period of 2 seconds. They are so constructed that they can be donned within a minute and can turn the body of an unconscious person face up, allowing him to breathe. Life jackets are fitted with a whistle and a fixed or flashing light, which burns for at least 8 hours. As far as possible, jumping into the water must be avoided, and ladders and ropes must be used to board survival crafts. However, if it is necessary to jump, the height must not exceed 4.5 meters. And the life jacket should be clasped firmly to the chest by one hand and the nose blocked by the other. Life buoys are made up of inherently buoyant and non-inflammable material. A grab line is secured to the life buoy in 4 loops. Life buoys may be attached with buoyant non-kinking lifelines or self-igniting lights. Man overboard life buoys, normally located near the bridge wings, are attached with self-igniting lights and self-activating smoke signals. Immersion suits are made of waterproof material and will not sustain burning after being totally enveloped in a fire for a period of 2 seconds. Immersion suits can be donned in 2 minutes without assistance and cover the whole body except the face. The immersion suit will permit the person wearing it to perform all the normal duties associated with abandoned ship. Immersion suits complying with the requirements of a life jacket may be classified as a life jacket. Alternatively, a life jacket shall be worn over the immersion suit. Thermal protective aids are made of waterproof insulating material and can be used to help people who have lost a lot of body heat due to immersion in cold water. It covers the whole body of a person wearing a life jacket except the face and is capable of being donned without assistance in a survival craft. The Global Maritime Distress and Safety Systems, or GMDSS, is specifically designed to automate a ship's radio distress alerting function. One of the principal advantages is that the system is actually an amalgam of various individual radio systems consisting of a VHF radio capable of transmitting and receiving digital selective calling, DSC, and radio telephony. A medium frequency radio telephone installation, an Inmarsat ship Earth station with enhanced group calling for receiving safety, weather, navigational warnings, etc. A nav text receiver used for the automatic broadcast of localized maritime safety information. EPIRB, or Emergency Position Indicating Radio Beacon, is designed to operate with satellites, including polar orbiting satellites. Its signal allows a satellite to accurately locate the EPIRB and identify the vessel anywhere in the world without any range limitation. Rescue coordinated centers are subsequently alerted via the satellite and rescue crafts dispatched to the casualty. EPIRBs can be operated either manually or automatically with the help of a hydrostatic release unit. SART, or Search and Rescue Radar Transponder. This is a buoyant, portable, manually operated locating device which is triggered by the radar beams of ships and aircrafts. A series of response signals are generated when interrogated by radar, and these signals produce blips on the radar screen of the rescue ship or aircraft. 3 sets of two-way handheld VHF having International Radio Channel 16 and other channels are used for emergency communication between ship and survival crafts. Early action during a man overboard situation is the key to saving a life. If a person is seen falling overboard when the ship is underway, the nearest life buoy or other buoyant object should be immediately released, the alarm raised, and the helm put hard over to the side from which the man has fallen. The signal O can be made on the whistle and corresponding flag hoisted to warn the vessels in the vicinity. For the ship to return to the position where the man had fallen overboard, the Williamson turn is a maneuver commonly used. After turning under full helm through a deviation of around 60 degrees, the rudder is put hard over in the opposite direction to bring the vessel around to the reciprocal of the original course. In case the casualty is not located, a search must be initiated immediately using suitable search patterns like the sector search and the expanding square search. The rescue boat is launched as soon as the casualty is sighted and a lee made by the ship to facilitate the rescue. Modern ships are provided with sufficient number of partially or totally enclosed lifeboats on each side so as to accommodate all persons on board. Totally enclosed free-fall lifeboats are located on the vessel's stern. A lifeboat has a rigid hull, is made of non-combustible material, and shall have buoyancy chambers capable of maintaining positive stability with a full complement of crew and equipment. Hatches provided in the cover provide rapid embarkation and disembarkation for the crew. These hatches can be closed from inside and outside to make the boat watertight. The boat is self-righting even when fully loaded, and safety belts are provided to secure the occupants to their seats. Every lifeboat is fitted with a compression engine with either a manual or a power starting system. Ahead, astern, and neutral gears are provided. The engine can propel a fully loaded boat at least 6 knots and at least 2 knots when towing a fully loaded life raft. The lifeboat is steered by a rudder, which is controlled through the steering wheel. Many lifeboats are fitted with a steering nozzle, which is hydraulically operated. This system provides excellent thrust and maneuverability. Should the primary steering fail, the emergency tiller is used by fitting it directly over the rudder stalk and disconnecting the transmission system to the steering wheel. A sprinkler system is provided on the lifeboat, which covers the entire surface of the lifeboat with a film of seawater, thus protecting the boat and its occupants from rapid increase in temperature if the boat is engulfed in flames of a ship on fire. On chemical tankers and gas carriers, which emit toxic vapor or gases, the lifeboats are fitted with compressed air cylinders which supply sufficient air to the inside of the boat when the hatches are closed. Pressure valves are fitted to maintain the atmospheric pressure inside the boat. Modern ships are fitted with gravity davits which use the weight of the lifeboat to lower it into the water. Lifeboats lowered by falls are fitted with a release mechanism which unhooks the two falls simultaneously by the pull of the lever. A locking device prevents unintended unhooking. Free-fall lifeboats, on the other hand, have an inclined launching system which uses the natural force of gravity, allowing a totally enclosed, fully manned lifeboat to simply slide down a ramp and plunge into the water below, even if the mother vessel has a list of up to 20 degrees. To initiate the free fall, the craft is fitted with two independent hydraulic systems, one as the primary launching system and the other as an emergency backup. Pumping either of the hydraulic pumps will raise the boat's stern clear of the davit housing, allowing the boat to free fall. An A-frame with a pivot point at the lower end of the launch ramp, complete with hydraulic winch and cylinders, allows for the recovery and launch by wire of the lifeboat. Rescue boats may be rigid or inflated and have a capacity of at least 5 seated and 1 lying person. The bow is covered for at least 15% of its length. It may be fitted with an inboard or outboard engine capable of giving the boat a speed of 6 knots for at least 4 hours, or tow the largest life raft on board when fully loaded at a speed of 2 knots. All cargo ships are required to carry at least 1 rescue boat. A lifeboat may be accepted as a rescue boat if it complies with these requirements. An inflatable life raft is a round or oval-shaped raft, its source of buoyancy being inflatable tubes on its periphery, which are made of rubberized cotton or nylon fabric. The whole raft is neatly folded and packed by the manufacturers in a compact fiberglass container. A senhouse slip in the securing strop permits quick manual release. A painter attached to the life raft leads out of the container and is connected permanently to the ship to a strong point. To launch the life raft, the container is thrown overboard and the painter pulled out, giving a sharp tug to the painter opens the valve of the gas cylinder and inflates the life raft. Arches for supporting the canopy are also made up of inflatable tubes. They are connected directly to the upper buoyancy compartment by a non-return valve, so that the canopy arches inflate and the canopy is erected automatically when the life raft inflates. The raft is fitted with at least 2 diametrically opposite entrances capable of being closed from inside and outside. At least 1 of the entrances is fitted with a ramp for boarding the raft, while others might be fitted with ladders. 4 adjustable water pockets help in reducing the drift and give stability to the life raft from capsizing. Means of collecting rainwater are also provided. For righting a capsized raft, 2 righting loops are provided under the life raft. The raft should be turned into the wind. The person should stand on the air cylinders, catch the righting loops with both hands, and lean as far as possible. The raft will catch the wind and start righting. A life raft, which is secured to the ship's deck using a hydrostatic release unit, will automatically cause the life raft to release from its lashing before it reaches a depth of 4 meters below sea level. This allows the life raft to float free on the sea surface, making it available for survivors. Much of the equipment carried in lifeboats and life rafts is the same, except for a few exceptions. The equipment consists of food rations in airtight packages, fresh water, a first aid kit including seasickness tablets, fishing tackles, knife, tin opener, a graduated drinking vessel, a buoyant bailer, buoyant rescue quoits with buoyant lines to rescue crew stranded in water, sea anchors with a hawser and tripping line for sea streaming, whistle, radar reflector, waterproof electric torch suitable for Morse signaling, a heliograph or daylight signaling mirror, distress signals consisting of 4 rocket parachutes, 2 buoyant smoke signals and 6 hand flares, a copy of life-saving signals and survival manual giving instructions for survival at sea. Life rafts carry hand pumps and plugs for repairs. The visual distress signals consist of rocket parachute flares, which when fired vertically reach an altitude of 300 meters and release a red flare which burns for at least 40 seconds. Hand flares burn with a bright red flare for at least 1 minute. They are to be held in hand on the lee side of the craft and are effective even in daylight. Buoyant smoke signals emit smoke of highly visible color at a uniform rate for at least 3 minutes. They should be activated and thrown into the water on the lee quarter of the craft and are most effective in daytime. Disasters strike without notice. Only proper training in the use and maintenance of survival equipment can save your life.